All right. So right now we discuss different illustrations of partial integration. Steps were very simple. Step one was tax on total income, including agriculture income. Step two, tax on agriculture income plus basic exemption limit. Step three, step one minus step two. Step four, thinking about rebate. If it is applicable, then provide. And step five, add says. One more time, let's do it. It is written in your module as impact of agriculture income on tax computation. Again, I'm telling you, we are not taxing agriculture income. We are just taxing non-agriculture income at higher rate. Okay, that's the purpose of these steps. Okay, your institute has given also in step manner, step 1, step 2 and step 3. They have written only 3 steps because as a professional student, because only there is a difference in only first 3 steps. Step 4 is same, step 5 is same. Every time I'm telling you, every time after computation of whole tax, final step is garnishing and that is says. Never ever forget step, okay? Your institute has given one example, Mr. A, age 42 years. So what will be his basic exemption limit? 2.5 lakh. Having non-agro income 3,25,000. Okay? And agro income 2,55,000. Compute his tax liability. What were our condition? First condition. Assessor should be individual HUF AOP. Mr. me? Individual. Second, agriculture income should be more than 5,000. 2,55,000. Is it there? Alright? And third is, taxable income should be more than basic exemption limit. Yes, sir, it is there. All right. So then what we do? What do we do? Now step mechanism will be activated. Different mechanism of computation of tax will be activated. And in that mechanism, what is the step one that we have discussed? Step one, tax on total income including agriculture income. So 2,25,000 plus 2,55,000. How much? Use your calculator. 5,80,000. So we need to compute 5,80,000 for ordinary citizen in India up to 2.5 lakh nil. 2.5 lakh to 5 lakh, 5%. That is 12,500. Alright, and above 5 lakh, how much is earning? 80,000. 80,000 multiplied by 20%. 16,000. And earlier 12,500. So 28,500. Are we clear about this 28,500? Okay. Then step 2. Tax on agriculture income plus basic exemption limit. What is my agriculture income? 2,55,000. Basic exemption limit? Basic exemption limit? 2,50,000. Total? 5,05,000. Compute tax on 5,05,000. How will you compute tax on 5,05,000? 2.5 lakh nil. 2.5 lakh to 5 lakh, 5%. That is 12,500. On 5,000, 20%. 1,000. So 13,000. Total tax on 5,05,000 is equal to 13,500. That is 13,500. Step 3. Step 1 minus step 2. 15,000. That is net tax. Okay. Now you need to think about rebate. Will you get rebate? Your total income, non-agro total, taxable income is less than 3.5 lakh. Will I get rebate, sir? Yes. How much? 2,500. So net after rebate, it is 12,500. But that is not final step. We need to add 4% says, and that will be 500. And final tax will be 13,000. This is again your homework. Are we clear about this? I'm almost done with this chapter. You can see now next chapter is starting there. One help I need from your side, very simple, okay, that is a theoretical question, but sometime it comes in exam. They will give you illustrations of what is agriculture income and what is non-agriculture income. Gradually you will understand. You will understand it through GST, you will understand it through income tax lecture, PGBP, IFOS. In some or other chapters we will be coming to this particular point. But here they have defined agriculture income extensively. Definition of agriculture income is given in section 2 1A. What is exactly agriculture income means? Alright, and definition of agriculture income is means definition. That means exhaustive definition. That means according to you, if you sell chicken, hens, alright, or eggs, you may feel I am doing agriculture activity. But that's not agriculture activity. You might be extracting milk from cows and you are selling milk. You will feel that it is agriculture. No, it's a dairy farming. It's not agriculture. You understand? So your understanding of agriculture can be different than their understanding of agriculture. Their understanding is agriculture, your understanding is not agriculture. Because the definition is means. Okay? Why definition has to be means? Because anything which becomes agriculture is exempt. Tomorrow I may come here and I will say, I took seminar on agriculture activities, so my income, professional income is agriculture income. No, that is not possible. You understand? People would have manipulated in the definition itself, and therefore government has given us exhaustive definition. Beta, this is what agriculture. Anything which is not covered here is non-agriculture, and that is taxable. So what is covered here? Any rent or revenue received from derived from land. If you are having agriculture land and if you derive any rent and revenue, then that is agriculture income, which is situated in India and used for agriculture purpose. The purpose has to be agriculture. If you have agriculture land, if you give to Rambo Circus, then circus is not agriculture activity. So there is an and. You understand? It has gone to Supreme Court level also, some cases. They have given some cases here. Okay? And a rent may be in cash or kind. You know, in villages, sometimes they give rent in cash and sometimes they give 40% of production. So 40% of rice will be given as a rent. So it can be in kind. So they are writing this additional point. Any income derived from such land by agriculture, by doing agriculture, by doing cultivation, some activity. Any income derived from such land by the performance by cultivator, okay, receiver of rent, or any process ordinary employed by them. So some process we do on agriculture farm itself. Like if you have seen the rice farming, all right, rice will be on that some small plant, no? And then you have to detach that dhan, okay, paddy, we call it paddy, okay, from the thread, okay. So you'll apply some process on farm itself. Secondly, if you are having cashew farmer, okay, you are having cashew plants, then you need to collect those cashews and you will put on your farm for sun drying. Alright, some process, same thing happens with groundnuts. You need to extract groundnuts, you need to remove them from plants, and then again you have to put for sun drying. So some basic process you will do. If you are a mango trader, then you will take mango, you will create those boxes, wooden boxes, you will put some grass into it, and then you will pack it. That packing is important to make the product sellable. Are you making jam out of it? No. If you do that, then it will become commercial. If you do basic ordinary agriculture operations, then it is not taxable, then it will be considered as agriculture. Lot of examples they have given, they have defined it in very nice term. Your responsibility only to read. I believe some of the words may be new for you, like curing means what, you know, some people don't know what is trimming, and some words they are using, alright. That you can see in dictionary or Google, and then you will understand the process, okay. So please read it. Wherever you are getting stuck, you ask me, I'll answer those queries. Okay? So we are done with chapter 3. Your exam will not be on agriculture income because this is too early for this chapter. We have just finished theoretically. Practically, it will be done only after PGBP. Because this is a part of PGBP. Okay? One business is done from PGBP. Agriculture business. Balance businesses are still yet to be done. Okay? So next week's exam on residential status on scope of total income. Okay, those two chapters should be focused upon. Thank you.